What is below our feet? It is more difficult to explore the Earth's interior than it is to explore the surface of other planets. The Moon, 238,000 miles away. The hellish surface of Venus, 38 million miles away. Or the surface of the Red Planet, 118 million miles away from us. Humans have inhabited planet Earth for roughly 300,000 years. And yet, the exploration of the Earth's interior is one of the greatest challenges still facing all of us, in particular geologists. There are two main underlying limitations that prevent us from exploring the Earth's interior: the intense pressure exerted by rocks and the ultra-hot temperature that keep increasing with depth. Given these challenges, it's very difficult to assess the Earth's interior. And because of this, there are many unknowns about the origin of shaking by earthquakes, what fuels volcanic eruptions, what hidden critical resources are in the Earth, and more. Therefore, these questions remain out of our reach, simply because there aren't many natural passages that allow us to enter inside the Earth. Caves excavated by water erosion can go as deep as 1 mile. In the 20th century, miners and craftsmen have been excavating inside the Earth to seek mineral treasures, such as diamonds, as deep as 2.2 miles. Coal, oil, and natural gas, composing the legendary trilogy of the fossil fuel legacy, have been extracted by drilling as deep as 6 miles. And yet, to date, 7.6 miles, the deepest borehole in the world, is the furthest we've been able to drill. Drilling has made it possible to assess the Earth's interior. But the thrill to drill has been quickly contrasted by the intense pressure and the ultra-hot temperature inside the Earth. And because of these fundamental challenges, we face one major problem, that we just scratch just the surface of our planet, barely. And the target, the Moon, is far, far away. The Moon is the boundary between the crust and the mantle on planet Earth. From the Moon, magmas rise and through the crust feed active volcanoes on the surface and configure many of the metals we need in our societies. Metals that will greatly advance our machinery, technology, and our daily lives. And so we have the opportunity to face a major problem that actually scientists, the whole community, has faced for over 60 years, to reach the Moon. And yet, the pressure alone at this boundary is about 12,000 times greater than our atmospheric pressure. So you can imagine how tough it is to drill inside the Earth. And because of this challenging to drill in such a high-pressure environment, simply, we don't have the opportunity with our present drilling technology to sustain it. And therefore, the Moon remains out of our reach. And throughout history, the Moon has been deemed impossible. Until now, the Dive Project. I'm a geologist at the University of Georgia with a great passion in exploring the roots of our continents. Specifically, I'm a petrologist who is not an expert of petrol, be aware of that. A petrologist is an expert of rocks because the word petro derives from the Latin petra, which means rock. About 14 years ago, my mentor, Luigi Burlini, who first sparked my passion in this journey inside the Earth, passed away. I was completely crushed, not only because I lost a mentor, but I also lost a dear friend. And to honor his legacy, I found a team of scientists who shared the same curiosity in exploring the continental roots. Together, we discovered a geological location in my home country, and this location can provide us the precious opportunity to reach the crust mantle boundary without having to go deep. Tucked away in the Italian Alps, not far away from the city of Milan, is the Ivrea Verbano Zone. Voilà. In the Ivrea Verbano Zone, we can reach the crust mantle boundary, or MOHO, after only 1 mile of drilling. This is because the tectonic collision forming the European Alps has brought such a frontier to a shallow depth closer to the surface, and therefore to conditions of lower pressure that now our present-day drilling technology can sustain. Our project is known as DIVE, short for Drilling the Ivrea Verbano Zone. And the DIVE team is on a journey to explore and reach directly the crust mantle boundary for the first time in history. We aim to assess the inaccessible just after a few miles below our feet. And therefore, we are able, essentially, to reach a frontier that nobody has explored before. Although we have not reached now the frontier yet, the DIVE project is providing us a better chance to explore the roots of our continents than ever before. Now that you know how much challenging it is to assess the Earth's interior, you may be asking, why the heck are we interested? Why is it so important to drill inside the Earth? Well, the thrill to drill is driven by two main reasons, discovery and life. Discovery has always been part of human nature. First, we aim to discover our foundations and our existence. And that understanding is tightly connected to unraveling the architecture of the Earth's interior, made of rocks. And here I call our superiors, the geologists, who have an amazing power, the power of reading rocks written in an ancient language. Here is an example of a rock that was retrieved during the first phase of scientific drilling of the DIVE project in fall 2022. This single rock, which is part of a 1,900 feet long coring, is an exemplary stony book that geologists are able to read. I introduce you the true rock star this night. Correspondingly, geologists are able to decipher the complex messages containing minerals forming rocks. Minerals have different colors, shape, distribution, dictated by the pressure, temperature, and time of geological processes. Minerals are amazing chemical containers, time capsules, messengers of ancient Earth, and the bricks forming our planet. And so geologists are able to decode these complex rock messages and unravel the cryptic geological processes that form that rock. This language is commonly found in fossils or in imprints left behind that tell us stories about extinct or past civilization and extinct species. Similarly, geologists are able to dive deeper and tell us stories of ourselves, where we come from, what we did, how we did them, and what resources we relied on in the past, and what resources we still rely on today. Second, we aim to discover the critical metals and minerals and other resources needed for our energy production. Therefore, drilling the crust mantle boundary is a precious opportunity to discover precious resources that will allow us to progress, resources that are needed for transitioning from fossil fuel legacy to clean energy. For instance, copper, cobalt, nickel, lithium. We need this metal to apply that transition. And not only, they could also reduce our carbon footprint and could significantly ease geopolitical concerns. Many of our everyday items are made of precious metals. One item in particular that we all dearly love, in some extent we are a little bit addicted to, right? Our smartphones are made of precious metals, composing the screen, the casing, the electronics, and the battery. So, paraphrasing the motto of an old advertisement for a drink, it is popular in Italy, no martini, no party, we can say, no metals, no phone, no progress, and no selfies. So, without these critical metals, we could not have advanced as much as we have since even the very beginning of times. And so, discovery is the gateway between science and research within our Earth. Now, studying rocky planets like Earth aids our understanding to the origins of life and its evolution through time and space. To the best of our knowledge, in our solar system, life is only present on Earth. Thanks to rocks, our dearest friend, and thanks to the generation, construction, deconstruction cycle of continents, we have an active, thriving biosphere on planet Earth that makes living plausible. This all made possible through plate tectonics. So Earth is a unique known planet with an active plate tectonics. And you can see this beautiful geological tango of continents that generate an ever-changing puzzle of their placement on Earth through time. The most amazing outcome of this tectonic tango is that life has been sustained for billions of years. So life is tightly connected to the presence of liquid water, which is derived from smoky volcanoes that help shape our atmosphere and our oceans. The combination of heat, liquid water, and nutrients derived from Earth's natural metals generate that fertile environment where life can be initiated at a microbial scale. And through billions of years, thanks to the geological patience, these microbes have been able to evolve to giant species like dinosaurs, or into more specialized intelligent creatures like dolphins and humans. But now, one question we pose in the DIVE project is whether life can be found and can survive inside Earth in either crust or mantle. Because of the high pressure of the rocks and the tiny pore space available between minerals, we could only expect to find life in the microbial form. Microbes are amazing because they are able to adapt in these tiny pore caves, form communities, and gather all the needed supplies from the surrounding minerals forming rocks. And so, if we find life under these extreme conditions inside Earth, will this lead our understanding of how life may be sustained in other terrestrial planets? So, mankind without Earth is a self-annihilation, guaranteed. Earth without mankind is another lifeless planet in the solar system. Crossing the boundary between the mantle, the crust, the mantle on planet Earth is not only a feast in Italy, it's not only a European matter, it's not even a project for geology nerds like me or crazy scientists in general. The project matters to all of us. The scientific mission of DIVE will provide us the power to boost our transition towards clean energy, to save our world from fossil fuel pollution, and to reduce geopolitical tensions caused by unequal mineral resource distribution. Therefore, our roots are made of precious metals and minerals. They are the frameworks that connect the narratives, they connect us to the narratives of our ancient past. They are the future for clean energy. They are the foundations of life as we know it. So therefore, before we take a step forward toward the future, it is imperative, in my opinion, to look down and understand what really lies below our feet. As a petrologist, again, not an expert of petrol, I invite you not to look at the stars, but to look at our roots. To the rocks. Go rocks!